75 to 100 pens. It's a very tight hole. All right, we call it the Colot. There's a guy named Kerry Colot. I went and watched a clinic or did a clinic at the Dapper Dan Classic with Kerry. I took this one, Bo and Mick were like 9, 8 years old, and it's in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. And I saw Kerry Colot teach this one. I saw it 10 years ago. I said, he's pretty freaking slick. I come back and show my team, but hey guys, new move. All right, we'll call it the Colot after Kerry Colot. He's a national champ, bad dude. And I showed my team, they're like, they just didn't pick it up. And then, guys, 4 years ago, my nephew, Ryan George, started pinning people with this move. Once he started pinning people with this move, then my whole team does. I got a guy right now named Alex Marinello. All right, he's ranked number one in the country, 160 pounds, he's a three-time state champ, special wrestler in Ohio. Going to be a four-time just verbal to go to the University of Iowa with the Brands brothers. And he's a pinning machine with this move. My son, Mickey, pinned his guy to win his 4th state title, pinning guy from Clyde. Bo May from Clyde to win his 4th state title. All right, real simple move, guys. Hey, guys, I'll never show you guys anything illegal, I promise. All right, this move, does it choke you? Oh, yeah, it freaking chokes. All right, is it legal? Completely legal. They made it illegal, guys. I quit teaching. The only thing this move is, guys,
they make it illegal.
That's all the 3/4 Nelson. Watson, grade school in the 70s. I knew the 3/4 Nelson. 3/4 is this. I stepped over Mario's leg. We have to have a hook. 3/4 is this. I reach up underneath, I grab his head, I tuck his head, then I take his leg with my leg. I take it over this way here, I stack Mario right on up, and I bend it. You guys with me? That's a 3/4 Nelson. All we're doing is a 3/4 Nelson, but we don't have the leg. Now watch. We're going to be right here. Partner, I'm going on all fours. I want your butt off your heels just to help you do the move. I'm going to come to a closed front headlock. All right, here's an open front headlock. Right hand's on the chin, left hand's on the inside top. Right here's an open front headlock. A closed front headlock is when I lock my hands. How I lock my hands, guys, it's up to you. How you want to lock. I like to lock this way. I like my right palm up, right by the chin, right here on the chin. I turn my right palm up. My left hand comes over top and it's butterfly lock. My thumbs are not outside. I've got my thumbs bare. Marinelli, guys. Or my son, Mickey, he likes to have his right palm down, left palm up. He locks this stretch. So I don't care which way you lock. Marinelli sometimes, guys, does the old cheesy lock like this. All right? And he still pins all kinds of people with it. My son, Mickey, state finals his senior year. He's going for his 4th state title. Takes this guy down with a head inside single chase angle. That's the move I'm going to show you guys next. Cuts him, takes him down again with a head inside single chase angle, and pins this guy in a cold lock. All right, doing his 4th. Anyway, here's the move. Right hand, palm is up. Left hand, palm is down. I'm right at his chin. Act like I got my lock. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to step my left leg up. Left leg steps up. I'm going to drive to my left knee. Now watch this, guys. I'm stepping around his right arm. I drive to my left knee, and then my right leg, guys, I'm going to come up and swing around behind me. Here. Notice, guys, Mario and I are parallel. We start here. I get perpendicular. Right back to parallel. Again, don't make this step difficult. It's easy. Here, left leg steps up. I drive to my left knee. Right leg comes up. I swing around behind me. And I get to right here. When I get to here, guys, you're going to see me change up. My butt cheek comes right down to my left heel. You're going to see my left shoulder drop all the way Mario's armpit to his chest. You're going to see my lock. That's right in his chin. You're going to see my lock do this. I'm going to come all the way over top of his head. And notice, guys, look at my elbows. Elbows, both my elbows are aimed straight to the mat. It has to be that way. All right? His neck is right between my forearms. This is where the choke comes in, guys. Honestly, I'm going to run across both carotid arteries. All right? Here, got the lock. Right below his chin. Step my left leg up around his right arm. Right leg swings around behind me. Look at this lock. As I'm going down here, guys, look at my lock. Lock comes all the way up. My left hand is all the way up over top. My lock's right here. He always lifts his head up. And then, guys, my right elbow comes down right here. That tight right there, Mario. Real tight, I promise. Here. And then, guys, I just man up, tuck his head, freaking shove into him. My shoulder's driving. Tuck his head, driving my arm. My shoulder's right there in the middle of his chest. And I'm in. A lot of reps, guys, are looking at this move. did a big referees meeting.
Yeah.
They called me up at the meeting. Hey, Coach Stewart, I want to talk to you about a move that you do that everyone's complaining about. This was last year. We ever watched the move? We don't know. I said, well, it figures, referees. I'm not talking about referees, all right? Coach is a referee. But anyway, I said, what's the move? It's like a front headlock, but you lock way up high. I think you're choking. I said, guys, it's just a front headlock. We lock up higher. I said, it's a three-quarter Nelson. We're behind the arm. I said, you going to outlaw a three-quarter Nelson? Oh, that's a good point. So you know what, guys? They're looking at this. Everyone in the area now is trying to do this move, guys. Why? Because we killed him. Here's what Hickey did. Took his guy down, cut him, took him down. First period, boat Mick. Here, lands right here. Mick's winning 4-1. Mick just leans back like this right here. Guy comes up. Mick does this. Reaches up and locks right here. And then Mick stepped off. Shoulder goes under. Here, elbow down here, tucked. Drove the guy over. And then, so you can do it offensively or defensively. All right. Here's the big mistake you see guys make. When you guys go do this, you guys don't step around. Your shoulder's not going to go into your chest, and you're going to keep this left elbow up here. You're going to try to crank it this way. It doesn't work that way. That shoulder goes all the way out. And my left hand, guys, I'm trying to reach
left
out
hand
out
the all way up.
Right here. And then, guys, when his head comes up,
you're gonna have
that's when his elbow comes down.
Palm of the hands on the back of the head. Remember that.
Real simple move, guys. Any questions on the call out?
No.
Let's try this.